Hi and hello to all. This side Priya Rana and this is the fourth lecture of management in which we are going to study about administrative approach and administrative approach include Henry Fayol principles. So Henry Fayol bring the concept of administrative management. Okay. He was appointed in a French company as junior engineer where he has certain experiences and from those experiences he has written his book Journal and Industrial Management which become very famous in the field of management. So he has given his 14 principles which we are going to study now. The number one is division of work. He has said that the whole work should be divided into different parts so that each individual should be assigned only one part of the work according to their ability and taste. Because if we recruit the right person at right place according to his expertise, then we can able to achieve the specification. Second is authority and responsibility. He said that proper authority should be given to the person so that he can able to fulfill his responsibility. Authority is to give the worker the power to fulfill his responsibility. Next is discipline. In discipline, he talked about that there should be obedient workers, respect for their authority and observance of established rules, the rules which are there in the organization, the people should follow that. So he talked about discipline for in an organization that there should be proper discipline in an organization so that there is a system of reward and punishment. And a good supervision should be there to see such things. Fourth is unity of command. In unity of the command, he says that an individual should receive orders from one superior only at a time. Because if number of superiors will give work to an employee, then employee get confused and couldn't able to achieve efficiency in his work. Number two is unity of direction, in which he said that there should be one head for one plan. The reason being there should be one head for one plan. If this is a plan which I'm going to execute, there is one head. That means there should be one leader for that. Sixth is subordination of individual interest to general interest. That means that the worker shouldn't focus on individual interest. They should focus on general interest of the organization. See, if the organization interest will increase, ultimately the individual interest will also increase. So there is a subordination between these two interests. Seventh is remuneration of employees. See, if there is proper and fair remuneration among the employees, if there is fair remuneration among the employees, then what will happen is the workers will feel satisfied from their job. The workers will feel satisfied from their job. Next is centralization. See, the management should focus on the major working should be done at top level, and if the work can be given to the lower levels, small works which can be decentralized, that work should be given to the lower levels. And if there is some big work or some strategic work that is to be centralized, that work shouldn't go to another party. So we can say that superior should keep authority of taking important decisions, while authority to take small and daily decisions should be delegated to the subordinates, I can say. Scalar chain means this is a formal chain which is to be followed. See, in this there is a ranking. See, the work should be followed in a strict manner, in an order of strict manners. This would be a superior, then work should be delegated to this person and again to another person. So this is the chain which is to be followed from superior, from top to bottom. So this is the chain which is to be followed. This chain is known as scalar chain. So we can look that it refers to the formal line of authority which moves from highest to the lowest rank in a straight line. Next is order. According to principle of order, we can say that right person should be given the right job and right thing should be placed at right place. So in order we should take care of certain things that we are giving order to the right person to whom it will work, and the right thing we should be giving the worker the right thing which he can able to do. Next is equity. We should think that we should treat everyone equally and impartially in the organization. We shouldn't be injustice. We shouldn't perform such kind of partiality in the organization. We have to be kind and just to everyone. Next is stability of tenure. According to this principle, there should be a stability of tenure among the employees, which means that this employees wouldn't be changed frequently. The reason being, if they are stable, they are well versed with the environment. They can work efficiently in the environment because they have been working from the employment previously. They know the aura of the environment. That's why there should be stability of personnel to get a higher efficiency. Next is initiative. Initiative means the worker should feel satisfied and should have the capacity to express their feelings. So Fiol says that it is the duty of the manager to encourage the feeling of initiative among the employees for doing the work. How this feeling get increased? To have a proper communication with them, to let their thought come to us, and we should also tell them about the training things, about how to advance in the how to get advancement in the company, such kind of a thing. So there should be initiative from the workers' point of view and from the manager's point of view as well. 14th is esprit de corps, which means teamwork. This means teamwork. We shouldn't focus upon I and me. We should focus on us. That means we should feel the spirit, the team spirit among the subordinates, and we continuously put our efforts into that. So we have done with management. The full lecture is based on management, in which we have learnt about the meaning of management, the nature, the functions, and the approaches of management, the classical approaches of management. So the conclusion says that management work out with proper set of principles and procedures to be followed in order to achieve the desired objectives of the firm. Management has 6 basic functions, which is given by Koontz, that is planning, organizing, staffing, directing, and controlling. Management is universal in nature. These are the nature of the management which we have discussed: flexible, intangible, dynamic, result oriented, multidisciplinary. It is an art or a science. Next is there are 3 classical approaches which are followed in management: scientific approach, which was given by F.W. Taylor, administrative approach, which is given by Henry Fiol, and bureaucratic approach, which is given by Max Weber. So management has various levels of the organization also, that is low level, middle level, and high level. Thank you. So if you have any doubt, you can write on the comment section.